David and Victoria Beckham have been showing off their perfect family Christmas in the Cotswolds on their respective Instagram accounts during the past few days. However, despite the merriment and fun with their four children, the festive period marks the end of a tricky year for the couple. No doubt, they will be looking forward to closing the door on 2018 and starting the new year on a more positive note. With just days to go before 2019 kicks off, Mirror Online takes a look back at the Beckhams' worst year. Victoria criticized for her choice of models. Just 2 weeks into the new year, Victoria was accused of using an underweight model in her spring-summer 2018 collection campaign. Fans blasted the designer's social media posting of Lithuanian model Gaidra Dukauskaitė modeling her designs, claiming the latter was sickly skinny. Victoria had been under fire for her choice of models before, but insisted in 2015 she only cast healthy women. They're young, they're thin, but that doesn't mean they're ill. Rose with Mel B over Spice Girls reunion. Mel B has been harping on about a Spice Girls reunion for years, even suggesting they could perform at Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding, which didn't happen. Scary Spice finally got her wish when she managed to convince most of the girl group to reunite for a 2019 tour, with one notable exception. Victoria has frequently spoken of her wish to leave her posh Spice persona firmly in the past and focus on her fashion brand. However, it appears Mel B refused to respect Victoria's wishes and publicly blasted her for not taking part. In October 2018, it was claimed Mel B told Victoria to FK off, UBCH when the mother of four insisted her aversion to a reunion still stood. Speaking to The Guardian recently, Mel said, "Well, anybody who knows me knows that's my lingo, whether it be in a jokey way or whether I'm frustrated or annoyed. I'm sure it was something along those lines, because I want all five of us to get back together." When asked if Victoria responded to her foul-mouthed criticism, Mel replied, "I don't think there was one. Ha 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 ha. We're all on a group email, us five. There's lots of love and lots of history between all five of us, and between me and Victoria. Yeah, I'm feisty, and she can be feisty, too." Victoria criticized for royal wedding attire. She may be a fashion icon, but Victoria can still fall foul of style expectations just like the rest of us. Her decision to wear a dark navy dress, from her own collection, and a scowl, was widely criticized for being the wrong color to wear at a royal wedding, which usually adheres to traditional wedding etiquette. Although she was under fire for wearing such a dark color, the dress was a huge hit with fashion fans after Victoria fast-tracked the design to be available for sale. Describing the dress, Victoria said, "I went to a very special wedding recently and wanted to wear something that felt feminine and appropriate, but that also had a bit of an edge to it. This dress was the perfect choice. I felt great in it all day and knew I wanted to make it available for my customer this summer." Denying divorce rumors. It's not the first time the couple's 19-year marriage have been hit by rumors they're on the rocks. In June, speculation appeared on social media, claiming David and Victoria were planning to divorce and were due to issue a statement. However, their respective spokesperson vehemently denied the claims. "There is no statement due, no divorce, and a lot of Chinese whispers and fake social media news. This is all very bizarre and an embarrassing waste of time." Days later, they put on a public show of unity at a men's London Fashion Week event, despite being seated apart. However, they appeared in photographs holding hands and laughing together, cementing their marriage as rock solid. A few months later, the rumors were fueled again when David was a notable absence from the Beckham family's front cover of Vogue magazine. Victoria was joined by their four children for the October 2018 issue, although David did make an appearance on a special subscriber-only edition. In October, Victoria was said to be in tears after finding out David had given a candid interview about their marriage with Australian TV show The Sunday Project. The former Spice Girl was apparently unimpressed when the retired footballer admitted their relationship was difficult. He said, "To have been married for the amount of time that we have, it's always hard work. It becomes a little more complicated. You make difficult situations, like traveling away, being away from each other, you make it work." David swerves speeding fine. David was widely condemned by politicians and road safety campaigners for abusing the law despite admitting he was in the wrong. Road safety charity Brake said, It is hugely disappointing to see a role model like David Beckham shirking his responsibility in getting off a speeding prosecution on a mere technicality. At the speed Mr. Beckham was reported to be traveling, his stopping distance would be double that of someone driving within the limit. He should count himself very lucky that no incident occurred and tragedy was avoided. David was further blasted as out of touch as he joined wife Victoria and flew to Paris on a private jet to celebrate his legal triumph with £1,300 bottle of Grand Zex Grand Cru. Business trouble. This year saw Victoria celebrate the 10th anniversary of her fashion brand. However, despite rising revenues, the brand's parent company Victoria Beckham Limited, VBL, revealed an operating loss of £10.2 million in the year to December 2017, according to newly released accounts. Victoria enjoyed some success in 2018 with her limited edition range for US chain Target and a makeup collaboration with Estee Lauder. A year ago, Victoria raised £30 million from outside investors, after reportedly receiving a £5.2 million bailout from husband David in 2016. The shine wore off David's golden balls when he managed to avoid a speeding fine on a technicality. In September, David was thrilled when escaped prosecution for speeding after he admitted doing 59 miles per hour in a 40 miles per hour zone in the previous January. However, his lawyer Nick Freeman, aka Mr. Loophole, successfully argued David received his speeding notice outside the statutory 14-day window. Following the court appearance, Freeman admitted his client probably should have been convicted from a moral standpoint and urged the government to change the law.